I want it all before I'm gone.
For sure, I thought it was fine, but Bill.
Yeah, buddy.
A lot of action.
Wake up, everybody. Aren't you supposed to go to work?
No.
Huh?
I am recognized, don't
you have what? Aren't you supposed to be at work at 9 a.m.?
Yes.
Oh, well.
She didn't go.
I didn't go.
Oopsie. Oopsie, oopsie. You guys have fun last night?
Yeah.
All right.
Well, good morning, everybody. I believe today's day 21, the third week. Yours truly, 7 caches, 1 final table. Just checked player of the year. We are currently in 72nd place. Within striking distance, not with one win, but like if we win this one, we'll be in the top 10 or so, and long way to go. So we're in contention. We're putting up results, small, you know, just what do you call it, like little jabs at it. We need to have those big meaty scores down the stretch. A couple things, let's get to the comment section stuff. First and foremost, the reason my GPS, it's not a GPS, I use Waze when I'm driving. I know how to get to the Rio. But what's happening is there's a bunch of construction on the 15. So sometimes it's open, sometimes it's closed. And there's like, it saves me 20 to 30 minutes sometimes when it gives me an alternate route that might be faster. Like that's a lot. So, and that's happening, you know, two or three out of seven days. So I'd hate to be stuck in traffic and show up late. So that's the reason that is on. What else? Other stuff. GPS. Yeah. Oh. Other stuff. There's other stuff. Am I having one of those brain things again? Other stuff. Okay, so yeah. As you saw this morning, the girls stayed over there, you know, late. They don't want them drinking late at night. They were having fun. Those two girls are friends of Amanda's, friends of mine from before. That's one of them is, well, the two sisters of my ex, who was in the vlogs last year, if you guys remember. Those are her two sisters. They became friendly with Amanda. We remained friends and keep in touch. And so it was nice to see them come over, have fun, do their thing. Amanda is going to likely go down to the Rio today, put some money into her WSOP account so she can play the online tournament tomorrow and then the ladies event, which will be on Thursday, I believe. So that'll be fun. It'll be fun for me to sweat her. Fantasy-wise, like, you know, we're obviously not doing that great, but we do have two horses left. Brock Parker, I did check, is still in the PLO, short stacked or whatever, so I don't think that we'll get him in the stud, but maybe he'll make a deep run in that PLO. Lots of time left, but we're running out of it. You know, it's a little frustrating because I felt like I had a really strong team, and then a lot of the guys just seem to be like, just busting, like, insta-busting. All right, so we're doing good. We have 154,000. That puts us in about 13th place. In chips, and I, like I said, it was the best tournament I've played so far. Got to bring that same focus and attention to today, and if I do that, good things will happen. Got no money, but I'll work it out with my charm. Having a good time and doing no harm. It's gonna be all right, gonna be all right. Into the first level, we chipped up from 154 to 166. Way different table. It's like sanity, you know, like last night was insane. Raise, raise, raise. This one is a lot of raise and take it, a little more conservative. The last hand, or two hands before the break, had a big one where I raised with the Queen of Diamonds, up, got re-raised by the Jack of Hearts, and then Alan Boston, stud player extraordinaire, re-raised with the Four of Spades. I called, I caught the King, the Jack caught a 3, and the 4 caught a Deuce, went and checked around. On 5th Street I make 5s, so I have a pair of 5s now with Jack Queen. And, or sorry, with Jack, Queen, King, and a, you know, 3 diamonds. So I bet, just Matt Rapelstein calls. And on 6th Street, I catch the 3 of diamonds, and I have a pair and a flush draw. He catches the ace of hearts on 6. So he could have a flush draw here, or just the, you know, the dirty jacks. He checks, I bet. He calls. The river, I don't make anything, and he checks, I bet. And he tanks for two, three minutes, like a really long time. I'm like, oh man, throw those dirty jacks away, throw those dirty jacks away. He called, he had 8, 9 of hearts in the hole and caught a pair of 9s on the river. So, well, either that or he had the 9s, one of the two, but either way. I'm not sure, because you know, when people, instead, you don't, they shuffle the cards, you can't tell for sure what they started with. But
Yeah, so I like the bluff. I mean, it's a spot where I have to be bluffing sometimes, and it was a big pot. It was worth it, but and it almost got through. He's like, I can't beat anything. I'm like, then fold. All right, so on to the next level. So far, so good. We got 33 left. It's feeling good, feeling focused. The end of the second level, there's 25 remaining. Play slows at this point, you know. Chips, everyone's, you know, has a decent stack. We've got 215,000. The average is about 211. Again, you know, this feels like I don't know, you know, I had the weirdest thing, so I don't know, maybe this is insane, but like I feel like I can predict cards sometimes. Like it happens so often, and I feel it in this one part of my chest right here. Oh, speaking of, check out this new one. Hey, two for flinching. So I felt like there's a spot where I had two kings in the hole against and a queen. Frank raised with a king, I re-raised with the queen, and the five bring in called. Make a long story short, the five catches on a six and then a five, makes open fives, and I make fours. So I have kings and fours, solid. And I'm here, I'm like, oh my God, I think a five's coming right now. Boom, five. And but then luckily for me, behind the five was a four for me. So we made a full house and he just had the three fives. It was pretty clear to me he just had three clubs on the hand. So my reads are good. My intuition, the universe is conspiring to work with me. Aum, feeling good. We have a happy man in the building. The ruling has officially came in. This man side betted it and he won. The 25K will not count. How do you feel about that one?
I took a shot.
Vindicated.
I think, Ike and Phil and Somerville, pretty smart guys, rational guys. I thought it was the rational side and the right side, the just side. So I'm happy they made the decision. But if they didn't, if they chose the other way, I'd figure that I was probably wrong and I would have been all right with it. Whatever they decided.
So everybody's happy. Everyone's, actually, that's not true, but whatever. I don't care personally, but all right. So it does not count. It's official. Plane came in today and the arbitrator said they're going to not count the event. So c'est la vie. Let's move on. Win the stud tournament. I mean, we got some chippies over here.
Was full of shit.
It's like 19 left. 14 get paid. Like 856 players. What? 856. I don't even know what I'm talking about. 19 players left. On the next level here. Weird, crazy hand just now. And I'm doing really good. We have 400K in chips. Very strong. But I just played a weird one. See if she'll do some card graphic-y thingies. We'll see. It's a hand where Frank Casella limps with the nine of spades. John Hennigan raises with the king of spades. I call the queen of diamonds up. And I've got split queens and a nine, so I block that thing. So, make a long story short, by 6th Street, my board breaks into, the nine catches a three, a king, and a jack. John catches a 10, an eight, and a four. I catch open sixes, so I make, so catch a six, a six, and then a, the heck's the other card? We'll just say it's a deuce. Yeah, or a 10. No, it's a 10. What the hell? Give it a 10. Anyway, I bet, let's say the open sixes. Frank raises me with King Jack 9-3. John tanks. So when John tanks, I know he has two kings. It's completely board locked, right? Like, he doesn't have three nines because I got a nine. He doesn't have kings up because John's got the kings. He doesn't have Queen 10 because there's like two tens out and whatever. So it was like, what the hell can you have? Three threes is the only thing. But I re-raise with the queens up. Just to shut him down. If, you know, I don't think he's gonna bet the river unless he improves. So I re-raise, he calls, and then the river I check fold, and he shows three, well, he says he had three full jacks, makes sense. But really love where I'm at. I'm really seeing the game, you know, feeling the flow, the mojo, the whole deal. two tables, two away from the money, some stud geniuses on the right, and then the Russian with AJ, got Horsey, that guy's won a few, Volpe. It's my table. That's that one over there. So I'm going to tell the people about the low card, because this is what you do if you're a stud player. New table, eight-handed table. We are working on four in a row. Four low cards in a row to start the table. Let's see. Oh, it's got a shot. It's got a shot. It's got a shot. Ah, only four in a row. We stopped the streak.
Fucked up the blog.
Yeah, I messed it up. Working on a new streak now. So we were low card four in a row, but we've been top two in terms of low because we were the second lowest card. Six straight now, okay? Luckily, we won the last one because we raised that guy over there. Little fun, sneaky, sneaky hand. So next hand, we're looking at going seven in a row, lowest two cards. You can do it. You look happy right now. This is Boston, by the way.
Hi.
He likes seven-card stud, and he's upset that the young kids don't play it. You want them to revive the game. Should be all over TV.
I don't give a fuck what they're doing.
Hey, what's up, people? How are you doing? I'm filming this way. So hopefully tomorrow's the day off, right?
Yeah. Think that's what it's looking like right now.
Okay. I'm going to explain to the people the deal.
Too many tough players here. This is going to drag on.
So tomorrow I can play the online event. Yay! All right. So here's the deal. We are on the bubble of the stud. There's 15 players left. Thankfully, MJ just won a nice pot because he was really, really short. So he's back in it. Go fantasy team. I'm doing great with 530,000 in chips. We got a one-hour dinner break. There was a little discussion about whether or not, you know, we wanted to play until the money, but nobody's that short that we just decided to take the 1 hour break and come back on the bubble, which is unfortunate for whoever bubbles, but c'est la vie. Now, the other interesting thing that comes up is these events are scheduled for 4 days. Part of that is, the deal between PokerGo and CBS where they're filming, they're live streaming the events on the fourth day. So there's only 15 left. We're hopeful that we can play down to six tonight and then take the full day off tomorrow. I can play the online event, as I said. What would really suck is if we end the night with like eight people and then we got to come back tomorrow to play from eight to six, go home, and then come back. And that would be like kind of problematic. So I think everyone's probably going to agree to that. And if not, you know, we got to go with the rules. Whatever it is, you don't complain and whine about it because it's already written in the thing. We sign up for a four-day event. It is what it is, you know. Don't have to love it, but if you sign up, you better eat it. I gotta tell you, man, having this trailer is a blessing. We got the coffee for the stretch run. We got a good solid 30 to 40 minute nap in, feeling good, feeling ready. It's gonna be a grind. Lots of great players. John Hennigan, he's played like two tournaments. He's already here, you know, deep in the money because he's really, really good. Lots of good players. But if we play well and continue to focus the way we are, I'm gonna be a tough out, as I've said before. I feel really good about this one. Let's do it. Thank God, I can't believe I forgot to mention this, but guess what? You know Christian, all around athlete, does everything for the vlogs, the thing, whatever. He's got three beautiful girls, and right now, he's on his way to the hospital for girl number four. So congratulations to them. Really happy for them. Look forward to having their little one play with our little ones when we make that thing. So everybody give a warm welcome to the newest addition to the Christian Sanchez family. Cheers. All right, so we're still in the bubble. Scott Siever talked to the people, powers that be.
You want me to interview you?
You're good. He talked to the powers that be about what we're doing tonight in the odd event.
Take your seats. As of right now, I'm being told three more levels. We are in hand for hand. We are on the bubble. Dealers, deal one hand and hold.
Daniel's a much improved stud player.
One hand and hold.
So here's the deal. You're just like, listen to him say that. Phil
used to, I said used to be.
Oh, thank you. I appreciate that. So anyway, we're discussing what we're going to do tonight if we don't get down to seven. Tomorrow's an off day no matter what, but we'd like to get there tonight so we don't have to come in for an hour tomorrow. And I think we're going to be okay with that. Time continues to tick. Still playing hand for hand. Almost through the level. We've played an hour and 15 minutes. Nobody went broke. We got a Paul Volpe short stack. We got an MJ short stack. This is on the short stack table. Nobody there is short. And we're doing good. Look at that. Despite me beating him in a brutal pot, leaving him with one bet, our boy MJ squeaked into the money with a short stack. got the shorty, shorty, shorties.
And then we got big stack over here.
Good job, kid. Go team. Officially, we are in the money. MJ did a really good job battling there. There was a weird. I mean, it's like weird because like I'm not cheating. I would never do that. But like when I'm in a pot with him, when he was all in for like a bet, I was rooting for him because it was an insignificant pot to me. It's only like 10K, and you know, for the points and a lot of the bets I have, it's good. I mean, obviously wasn't gonna be disappointed if I won, but you know, I'd rather hit him. The key hand where I got him good was I raised with a jack and two sixes in the hole, and he had the ace of spades up, and he just flatted. He didn't re-raise me. I make open jacks. He catches a jack of spades. I bet he calls, and I have jacks and sixes. I bet he raises me. Yeah, I bet he raises me. And then on Fifth Street, he catches a five of spades. I catch a nothing. I catch an ace, actually. Not nothing. I check, he checks back. Sixth Street, I catch nothing. He catches the queen of spades, so he's got like four spades showing. I check, he bets, I call, because I don't think he ever has a flush here. I think he has aces a lot, just like split aces. And if he does have that, this leaves only one card in his hand that could be a flush. And I did have two spades as well, so I really didn't think he had a flush. You know, he might have had aces up, but, you know, there's a lot of time he's just going to have aces in a flush draw. So we call, I catch the six in the hole. Now the question is, do I bet out? He's got two bets left. Do I bet out? Or do I check raise him with the full house, which is always going to be good? I elect to bet out, and this isn't because I'm trying to save him a bet. It's simply because I don't think he is going to bet. Certainly not going to bet aces up on the river. And I think he might check back a lot of flushes because of tournament strategy on the bubble. So I wanted to get value for the hand. I bet he called. He had aces and jacks on 4th Street. So lucky hand there. We've got about 700K in chips. I think that's either chip leader or second. Pretty close. Very happy with it. The bubble was awesome. It really put a lot of pressure on, which is like a fun spot. So that is a fascinating game where, you know, you really have, I mean, it's just fascinating. I just basically was in a great spot with a bunch of short stacks who could not play, you know, so I could open like pretty, pretty wide. Anyway, having fun. Okay, so we just had a full house and we lost three bets on 6th Street, but it's good to know that John said I lost the minimum. Thanks, John. He also had a full house. His was bigger. Never feels like you lose the minimum when you lose three big bets on six, but we're still doing good. Yeah. Just got official word. Christian had his baby like 5 minutes ago. Congrats, y'all.
Who's Christian?
My buddy, Christian. You know you golfed with Christian before. Just had his fourth daughter. Crazy. Unbelievable. Mine is a pretty bunch right here.
The Motley Crew.
The Motley Crew, yeah.
Here we are.
There we go.
Grinders winning eight or better tournaments and eating salads.
What?
If you guys want to come back and finish tomorrow.
Finish the whole tournament tomorrow?
Tomorrow?
Yes. That's what
if
I want
to
do.
You want to. Hell yeah.
I want to finish. I want to play something else.
What's that? No, it'd be great.
I want to play something else.
For sure. Know. There's a 25K PLO then you could now play on day two.
Okay, so if you guys want, if you lose one more player, we can bring you back tomorrow and finish the stream at noon. You play at noon tomorrow until somebody wins. Or you can take the day off tomorrow and come back next day.
Yeah, no day off. Sure. Let's gamble.
Play tomorrow.
Play tomorrow.
Play tomorrow.
Is it unanimous and somebody left? Yeah.
He said whatever.
He said cool.
Whatever we said.
We're going to finish at, wait, I don't agree with it yet. We're going to finish at 2:30 and then we're going to come back at noon?
We finish tomorrow. As soon as we lose a person.
As soon as we get to eight people.
What if we don't lose a person?
If it goes long, we'll push.
I got three bets.
Oh, yeah, at this point. I mean, if it goes long, we'll push it back until 1 o'clock. I'm here.
Okay, so as you heard, we're going to, looks like, not have to do the day off thing and finish it out tomorrow as long as we lose one player. I don't know. Everyone seemed pretty agreeable, which is nice. Hopefully they stay that way, regardless of the chips. And speaking of chips, I've got 1.3 in chain, 1.35 million, which puts me in the chip lead. We'll be playing 15 and 30,000 limits. The plan is to play one more level tonight. It's another 90 minutes. And then the restart would be at noon tomorrow, so not a lot of sleepy time. You have to get right home, straight to bed. Alrighty, so day is over. Yours truly, sitting on 1.5 million in chips, which is good for the chip lead. Seven left. We will resume at 2 p.m. There is like an online tournament tomorrow, but guys, let's be real. I mean, I'm restarting at 2. The online tournament starts at 3:30. I got to focus. And stud is a game where you have to pay attention to up cards. So I don't think it makes sense. We'd be at a final table with a really good shot at a bracelet and sitting here in some $500. How's that? What the heck's going on? Some $500 turbo online tournament. You know what I mean? So not going to do that. We're going to focus on winning this bracelet and playing great. Funny thing happened on day one, sitting with Frankie O'Dell and Tom Correll. And I told Frankie, I said, I'll bet you $100 you don't win this tournament. He's like, all right, book. And then he's like, I'll bet you $100 you don't win yours. You don't win it either. I'm like, okay, book. He was at the final table. He busted eighth. And then Tom, I said, let's do the same thing. He's like, you know what? How about we just... If you win the tournament, I'll give you $100. You win, give me $100. So I have a swap, $100 swap with Tom Correll. I don't swap, but $100 seems worthwhile. So a great day, people. Three cashes in a row, eight on the series, jumping up the player of the year points, halfway through the series. Got to be happy with it, you know? Put together a big score here. And not only will we be doing good on all the stats, but we'll also be doing good on the big stat, which you'll see in a minute here, the tally, how much we're winning, how much we're losing. See you tomorrow, y'all. Final table.